僕は今地上400キロメートル上空にいます。ここから見る地球は青くて儚くて綺麗すぎて時々切なくなる。そんな時、決まって地上から僕を呼ぶ声が聞こえてきます。
希望日本実験棟、こちら筑波です。
地球を出発してから1年が過ぎて、僕は少しずつ成長しています。みんなが見守ってくれているから僕は頑張れる。この先どんな未来が待っているかわからないけれど、何か楽しいことが始まっている、そんな気がします。
March 11, 2008, the Space Shuttle Endeavour took off from NASA's Kennedy Space Center in the United States. To be constructed over three missions, the Japanese experiment module Kibo is Japan's first manned space facility. Signifying hope in Japanese, Kibo is part of the International Space Station, orbiting 400 kilometers above the Earth. Full-fledged construction of the station began in 1998, when the first components were launched from Russia and the United States. 15 countries from around the world pooled cutting-edge technology to begin a magnificent project aimed at producing something for the future of humanity. 2 years after the start of construction, three astronauts began long-term stays on the ISS. Progress on the station continued despite many difficulties, and it grew larger than a soccer pitch. Construction is now in the final stage, with completion targeted for 2010. One remarkable feature of the ISS is this module. It is Japan's first manned space facility, Kibo. Japan's participation was decided soon after the plan to build the ISS was announced in 1984. Until then, Japanese space development was focused on satellites. The launching of domestically produced rockets had also gradually developed.
日本の技術がもともと宇宙の有人技術がなかったので、コンセプト、概念を持ってっても、本当にできるのかっていう疑いの目と、作れないんだったら、ちゃんとアメリカのメーカーがいるから契約してくれればいくらでもサポートできるよっていう感じだったんですよ。
Japan wanted to build a Japanese manned space facility that would be acclaimed by the entire world. With Japan's prestige on the line, Japanese engineers worked together to advance Japanese space facilities.
Japanese engineers worked together to advance Japanese space facilities.
Various Kibo trials were being performed on Earth at the time Japan's first astronaut went into space.
ライトモデルを見せ始めて、いろんな試験をやったら非常にいいデータがたくさん出た。でその頃からなんですよ、フライトモデル見せて日本もできるんだねと言い始めたんですよ。あの見た目がすごく綺麗だし、確かにクリーンだし、いろいろチェックして、そういうのがだんだん出てきて、それが一個一個信用を多分得たんですかね。だからそういう意味ではあの日本のメーカーさんもそうだし、 JAXA の先輩後輩も、まあ、NASA もすごくサポートしてくれたし、いい結果になったみたいね。
Kibo is a beautiful spacecraft, and it's beautiful to me in two different ways. First of all, in form. It is a work of modern art created by craftsmen. But it's also beautiful in its function. It has tremendous capability as a spacecraft, and as an engineer, I find that very appealing as well.
In March 2008, the first Kibo assembly mission began.
いろいろ試験したし大丈夫だと思うんだけど、このアゲルダンになったら心配なんですよ。本当にうまくいくだろうかというのがあって、上がっちゃったらね、助けに行くわけいかないしね、もうあれですよね、頑張れ一人でってそういう感じですよ。
3, 2, 1, 0, and lift off of Endeavour, going where east and west do meet at the international.
On March 14th, astronaut Takao Doi used a robotic arm to carefully position the experiment logistics module pressurized section into place.In that moment, Japan's manned space development took its first steps. In June, the second Kibo assembly mission got underway. Astronaut Akihiko Hoshide positioned the heart of Kibo, the pressurized module, into place and moved the experiment logistics module pressurized section.With the success of these two missions, Kibo became operational as the newest member of the ISS. In March 2009,
そうですね、大きさは大型バスぐらいの大きさですかね。
Astronaut Koichi Wakata.Became the first Japanese to embark on a long-term stay aboard the ISS. It has been about 20 years since the start of development of Kibo. The Japanese experiment module is entering a new stage of its life.Kibo consists of five main modules. The core of Kibo is the pressurized module, where astronauts conduct experiments and research. Experiment samples and equipment are stored in the experiment logistics module pressurized section. The remote manipulator system is an essential tool for moving equipment around.The exposed facility is used to monitor and observe space and Earth. And finally, the experiment logistics module exposed section, which is a transport module for experimental equipment. These five components were divided into three groups for transport to and assembly on the ISS. The first two missions focused on the assembly of the experiment logistics module, the pressurized module, and the remote manipulator system. When the third mission assembles the exposed facility, Kibo will be complete. The third mission will be conducted just before astronaut Wakata returns from his long-term stay on the ISS. The exposed facility will be transported aboard the space shuttle. Wakata and fellow astronauts will manipulate the robotic arm to connect it to the pressurized module. The experiment logistics module exposed section will be attached to the end of the exposed facility. Following this, equipment on the exposed section will be moved to the exposed facility. When complete, Kibo will be the largest component of the ISS.
The Kibo module is a great addition to the space station from a research capability. It also has the facility, the exposed facility, to actually do research that's outside in a vacuum. So a significant increase, even though it's the third of the major laboratories to be added to the ISS, it's actually the largest. So a significant increase in capability from that point of view.
Through its link to ground-based mission control and payload flight control, Kibo is being used to exploit the unique environment of space in the fields of science, medicine, and the arts.
Kibo をよりせっかく作ったんですから、どんどんどんどん使ってもらって、使い尽くしてもらえばいいかな。それも日本だけじゃなくてアジアの、ね、諸国のメンバーの仲間ですからね、世界で使っていただいて、それが人類に貢献できるようなものを発見したりとか、きっかけができるようになるとすごくね、嬉しいでしょうね。実験棟らしくなったでしょ、最近あんなにすごくかっこいいようになるとは当時は思ってなかったですけどね。
Kibo represents the latest in cutting-edge Japanese technology. Its completion is the prologue of a future full of limitless opportunities.
Now, in my mind, there are many dreams and hopes that are born. How did I born?何のためにここにいるのか、ほんの少しだけ分かった気がします。僕は今、希望のその先にある未来がとても楽しみです。